It's VisCoastCone24 here, bringing you a real quick redstone video. Today I'm going to be showing you how I build my cave doors. I use a very close-defined algorithm for laying out the piston extenders, and I'm just going to be trying to show you how I do it. It is best used for 7x7 and above. Anything below that, you can make much, different layouts for, and you don't need to use as much slime for those ones that you would be using if you were to use this algorithm. It's just best for 7x7 and up because it's quite extender efficient, and it also is designed to be avoiding the unreliability as much as possible. If you go to the back, you'll see it makes that formation, and there is a method to this madness. So as you can see here, there are some linear progression stuff. You know, the placement is in many ways linear, and the amount of slime is in many ways linear. Now if I go over here, you'll see some similarities. You see 3 slime, 2 slime, 2 slime, 1 slime, 1 slime. If I go over here again, you'll see 3, 2, 1, and then of course the other 2, 1. It's all the same across these examples, they just serve different purposes. This right here is supposed to show you where the blocks go when they are retracted. So this red represents the blocks that will go into the floor. This orange represents the blocks that will go into their respective walls, and the yellow represents the blocks that will be pulled into the ceiling. Now, if you go to the back here, you can see that these slime blocks will be generally right up against the wall, ceiling, or floor that they would be generally pulled into. So, as you can see here, the piston extenders are under the floor there, and right here, these are all touching the floor. So, you know, it all just sort of wraps together nicely like that. Now, if I quickly go over here and show you, this is what it would all look like if I were to have built all the extenders from those two examples. And I will be showing you how I personally recommend you build these things, because there is actually a method that I use and a pretty easy, repeatable idea for this whole process, and I'm going to be doing it by showing you how I would build a 8x8 cave door using this layout algorithm, because these are odd. 7x7 is odd by odd, meaning odd amount of blocks wide, odd amount of blocks tall, but it's not. I haven't really shown you how the even by even works, so this will be a good way to show you the even by even. Even by even is different. It has pretty much the exact same idea, but it's built much differently, and it can be easy to confuse that with a completely different main idea. So generally, what you want to do is start off with the extender or extenders for the middle blocks. In this case, I'm going to start with the extender for the middle blocks that would be on the floor. I like to put them on the floor and the ceiling because my piston extender algorithm works best when it comes to vertical. Horizontal, it starts getting a bit iffy and you have to improvise. So, obviously, want to put the bigger ones on the vertical planes. So, to get the lengths of these extenders, or the extender, depending on whether or not it is odd by odd or even by even, take the height of the door, divide it by 2, and if it's odd by odd, you'll have to round up. That is the length of the extender. So, take 8, divide it by 2, it's not odd by odd, so I don't have to round anything, and that gives me 4. Now, that is the length of the extender. You're going to need 2, because of course, 4 plus 4 equals 8, but 4 and not another 4, it won't equal 8. No, simple math. Now, the way you determine the amount of slime to put on top of the extender is take the length of the extender, in this case 4, and then subtract 1. 1, 2, 3 would be the answer, and then put that one there. But you'll say, hey, hold on, that can't be the middle, because that's 1. 1 isn't the middle of 8. Won't be the middle of 8. Like, if you've ever built a house before, you'll realize that the houses that are an even amount of blocks wide require a double door, and odd requires a single door. Sort of the same way here, only in this case, it's 2 wide extender as opposed to 1 wide extender. Now, I'm going to be doing one-sided, so I'm only going to need to have one side with blocks, just like so. And because the back of it won't actually be shown when the door closes, I can simply prevent the slime from picking up other floor blocks by putting in obsidian. Now, I'm just going to really quickly build out the floor here, just like so. And what you want to do is subtract 2 from odd by odd height, or subtract 1, no, subtract 2 from an even by even's door height, and subtract 1 if it's odd by odd, and then you do that for this next part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 8 minus 2 is 6. Reason for this is it makes it so that you don't actually have to go over or under the amount of, like, floor space that will be needed for you to get in these pistons right here and everything in between. Once you've done that, you can do that for the other side too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very, very weird, but it works, and it's always going to be right. I've tested for pretty much every size of door through to 15 by 15 in a test world, and the algorithm has held true. Granted, not everything is, you know, exactly doable. As far as I know, 14 by 14 and above are going to be near impossible, but, you know, it still holds true in terms of building. Now, to get in the rest of the extenders, go down to your first extender, go up 3 from the bottom piston, and place out 2 blocks like that. Because this is an even by even sized door, you're going to have to place another one so that it takes up these 2 middle blocks of the door. See? 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3. Like that. It's 8 wide now. And so, to both sides of this, you're going to want to put in your next extenders. These will be starting at the bottom, and will be one less from the extender that came before them, just like that. Now you can put in your slime, and again, like I said, length of the extender minus 1 equals 2 for triples. Now go up 3 from the bottom, 2 blocks, and in this case you're going to want to go and put your piston extender closer to where the walls are. So like that, and then like that. Break out those temporary blocks, and then put in your slime. 2 minus 1 is 1. And then go 3 up, and yes, there is not a piston there. But that doesn't matter. 2 out, and then a sticky piston facing up. This is it right there. Then do the same thing for the other side, and you are done. You can't go up 3 from the bottom of this one, because that's in the middle of the door, so you're finished. Now, in order for you to finish up the door, so if I were to push all of those extenders out right now, for one, they would grab onto way too many blocks, because I haven't put in the obsidian yet, and two, they would also miss a few. Reason for this is, as you can see, the cave door will go in like a V, so sort of like that. But none of these extenders are actually taking care of those blocks right there. As you can see, there's no slime connecting. What you have to do is you have to start the algorithm all over again with your single piston extenders right there, and then you place it in, just like so. Oop. Put that back. And then, boom. Yeah, done. Those are all the sticky pistons and slime blocks you will need for the bottom. And this repetition of the algorithm actually continues, and when it comes to the way that this works, you will actually start getting extenders like that, that require slime, right in the middle, and that's when things start getting complicated. So, yeah, there are ways to wire it, but that's a bit too much for this video. I actually wouldn't be able to get this video out if I had to explain everything for the larger sizes. Now, in order for you to make it so that these extenders don't grab onto too many blocks, you have to realize that the blocks to the back and to the side closest to the door, not to the door, to the walls, those 2 blocks there, if this slime were to push them up, wouldn't be seen. Therefore, they're not necessary. Then if you just put immovable blocks, they won't be moved, because obviously immovable blocks can't be moved, they're immovable. And do the same for every extender. Back and one to the wall, place with obsidian. Now go over here, same thing, back and one to the wall, obsidian, back and one to the wall, obsidian. And that's it. That's your obsidian and your sticky slime layout done. For the walls, I always like to start off by just simply building up the entire wall. I always do this for all of my tutorials because it's a really, really good way to simply see how much space you're working with here, and it also makes it a lot easier for you to figure out pretty much everywhere that the extenders will be, because you can, you know, look at the height of it or where the middle blocks are. It just really generally helps with determining location. So, once you've got that built out, here's how you determine the location of your next ones. You find the, like, position closest to the back of these extenders here, your quadruples, or your quadruple if it's a 7x7. And then you go over to the wall, find the same layer, and then find the middle of the wall and break out the two blocks that would be there or the block that would be there. Place it with obsidian. Now right there is going to be a nice placeholder. This right here is going to be what your triple piston extender for the sides will be moving. Put another block right there. I prefer to put it up because if it's placed up, it allows for you to do a lot more in terms of wiring. It's a lot easier to power from the top than it would be the bottom. And now you're going to want to do the same thing. One, two, three. Three from the back of the extender. Go two and then build one down in this case because you have to take up those two blocks right there. Then your next extenders. One block shorter than the one that came before. Then, of course, length of the extender minus one, so one slime for the doubles. And then you're going to go one, two, and then put your single piston extenders right there. And then one, two, single piston extender right there. And that is your side layout completed. You don't need any of these extra bits because, as you can see here, if I quickly build up that, this will be taken care of by those slime blocks right there when it extends. Now, where you figure out where to put the obsidian is a bit different here, but pretty much the same. If it's on the floor or the ceiling, you see which of the blocks is closest to the wall. So, for example, down here, this block right here is closest to its respective wall, and thus you replace it with obsidian. That one is closest to the back. Well, for these ones, you find the ones that are closest to the back, and then you find the blocks that are closest to either the ceiling or the floor. For the top ones, it'll be the ceiling, and for the bottom ones, it'll be the floor. And then the same thing applies for the triple, but in this case, you just have to put it all around. And there you are. You're done. Obsidian and slime and sticky piston layout, done. I'm not going to be showing you the other side, because it's quite literally just an exact copy, but I will be showing you the ceiling, because although it is, in this case, an exact copy of the floor, the way that you build it is going to actually be slightly different, just to make it a bit easier. So for the ceiling, I also like to just simply build up everything. You do later on have to end up breaking through some of the blocks to get access, but, you know, it still is a good way to quantify the task ahead. Now, quickly build all these out. There you go. And then it's going to be the exact same obsidian, just on the ceiling. So find these two blocks, go up here, break, break. Then you see those two blocks right up here, break, break, obsidian. And then right there would also be two blocks of obsidian. Oop, another two. And then just one. Another two. And then just one. Now, going to start off with your quadruple piston extender or four piston extender, and then build up your three like that, because again, it's just a copy of the bottom, but flipped upside down. And now go up here, one, two, three, four. Going to have a placeholder block right up there, and then your four pistons placing down, facing down. Go three from the top in this case, out two, and then put your next set of extenders facing down on either side, just like that. Break it out, and then one, two, one, two, whoop. Then for this one, you're going to have to break out a few of the floor blocks just so you can get a good amount of space to work with, and then go down into one of those holes, and then put your next piston extenders, break out the placeholder blocks, and then you can fill back in your roof, ceiling, and there you are. Again, length of the piston extender, minus one. Two for the triples, and then one for the doubles. Then, of course, two blocks out. Like that. And then like that. Boom. And there you are. That's it. Minus one wall. But, you know, just a copy mirrored. And that's it. That's kind of it for this video. I hope it was coherent. And now, to sort of try and recap everything with the most extreme example I have, because this one actually makes it really, really easy to see how things would scale up if you were to continue the layout algorithm. to an extreme, like an absurd extreme. So if I go to the back here and show you, you can see a lot of similarities to the 7x7, and it has a very, very satisfying looking back. I actually really like the back, personally. But you can see here, you have your doubles, your triples, your quadruples, but now you have quintuples and hextuples for the sides, and then the bottom has a septuple. Those are really just fancy words for saying 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then also 7. Yes. I'm not being smart right now. These big words really don't mean anything other than just numbers. So, now that you've seen that, it's just sort of the exact same thing as the 7x7, but scaled up to an extreme. And these blocks, these piston extenders will all be grabbing their own respective blocks. As you can see right here, this one is grabbing onto those three blocks. No other slime extender is grabbing onto them. And, you know, same thing with the double piston extender. It's not got anyone else grabbing onto its blocks. It's grabbing onto its own three blocks. The only times that they start to share is when they are close up to each other, like that. Those two will share. Then, right in here, you'll see those two will also share. And if I go right up here and break out this block, not that block, sorry. This block, no, okay, that block. You'll see those three right there will also share that block. And that's pretty much it. I hope that this video had a coherent enough explanation. I sort of rushed it, but that gotta keep it within reason so that my phone can upload it. But, you know, that's just about it. Hope you enjoyed this real quick video explaining, in the best way I could explain, how I've been making these cave doors. I think a better way to explain it would just be in person, though. Oh, boy. But, yeah, that's just about it. I'm ViscosCone24, and I'll see you next time. I'm really sorry if this wasn't easy to follow. I really am having difficulties explaining this, because it's mostly just in my head, and putting it into words, it doesn't come out right, and just, I'm sorry. If it could be followed, that, thank goodness, and if not, I apologize very deeply for that, but, yeah, that's just about it for this video. I'm ViscosCone24, fuck you, Krappa, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.